Sea lampreys do a lot of damage on a lot of important game fish, like walleye, lake trout, steelhead, out in the Great Lakes. And if we can stop them before they spawn, it's a lot easier to deal with them here than it is out in the lakes. Typically, the sea lamprey run when the water starts warming up in the springtime. Once you start to get above 50, we'd start to expect to see them then. So traditionally, there was a chemical treatment done to kill sea lampreys, and we're looking for some alternative methods to stop them from coming upstream. And this is one option that we're trying to pursue here. The barrier setup applies electrical current to the water, and it hopes when the sea lamprey comes upstream to spawn, it hits that barrier and is deterred, and then we can do a treatment below that barrier and treat less mileages upstream.
One reason that the barrier is put in this section of Conneaut Creek is we have several state-listed federal and threat and endangered species in this upper section of the watershed, so we're trying to protect from treatments in the upper section of Conneaut Creek.
The net is kind of another alternative, and we're using it right at this location as a check to see, one, if lampreys are making it this far, and we have a net set upstream to see if the barrier is in fact working and we're not getting lampreys past the barrier. The barrier itself was set up from folks from the United States Geological Service. They're the ones that have the expertise behind that. They've come out from Michigan, they set it up, gave us a lot of demo on how it works and how to operate it. The netting part is through U.S. Fish and Wildlife Service, and we have some other strategic locations set up around the Conneaut Creek drainage that we're going to check later today. And it's DEP and the Pennsylvania Fish and Boat Commission are working in cooperation with them to help check and monitor what's going on at these sites. The sea lamprey is part of an ongoing tagging study, so it's going to get fin clipped, and then it'll be released further downstream. And then if it gets caught again, then it gives you an estimate on the population of sea lampreys in the system. So every day someone's going to come out and check the barrier for debris accumulating along it. We're also looking, monitoring it, if there's any dead fish, you know, that might have got caught in there in shallow water. So we're recording, you know, species, length and weight and stuff like that to make sure we're not having any harmful impacts on native fish that may have encountered the barrier.